Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to our webinar on certification, authorization and approval. For over a year now, ERA is the European authority in charge of vehicle authorization, safety certification and ERTMS trackside approval. And we want to use the occasion of this historic date to give you a return on experience of this time. And who better to do this than our executive director, Joseph Doppelbauer, and our head of the planning and approval delivery unit, Thierry Brain. They will give a 20-minute presentation, after which we will have plenty of opportunity to address all your questions. In order to pose a question, we invite you to write a message in the Q&A tool at any time, and we will address it after the presentation. We look forward to a lively debate, and with this, I hand over to our executive director, Joseph Doppelbauer. Joseph?
Thank you, Max, and good morning to everyone. I'm here in Valenciennes, as Max has said, with Thierry Brain, the head of the Planning and Approvals Delivery Unit. Good morning, Thierry.
Hello, Joseph. Good morning, everybody.
Indeed, the 16th of June is a historic date. On the 16th of June 2016, the technical pillar of the fourth railway package entered into force. And on the 16th of June 2019, ERA took up its new role as the European authority, initially with 8 member states on board. Today, on the 16th of June 2020, the transposition of the technical pillar should have been completed in all member states if it was not for COVID. Now, today, we have still reason to celebrate. And on the next slide, we show you what Thierry and I will cover in the next 20 minutes. We will first briefly come back to the measures that we have taken in order to mitigate the impact of COVID-19. Then we will review the achievements in our first year as European authority. We will cover some of the lessons learned, and then we will also discuss some areas of improvement and what we plan for the future. But before, I would like to remember the basic ideas why we are in the fourth railway package in the technical pillar. Rula, if we can go to the next slide, please. The technical pillar of the fourth railway package is a major step towards a single European railway area. On the example of vehicle authorization, in the situation before the fourth railway package, an applicant had to achieve the authorization for a vehicle separately in each member state intended to operate in. Now, with the fourth railway package, there is only one process by one authority, and everything is managed by the central element, the so-called one-stop shop. The one-stop shop is a web portal that connects the applicants, and we are speaking of single safety certificates, vehicle authorization, ERTMS trackside approval. The one-stop shop connects the applicants for these topics to the agency and to the national safety authorities. Remember, if you are in an area of use or area of operation in one member state, then the applicant may choose either the agency or the national safety authority. With an area of use in more than one member state, it is obligatory to have the agency as the authorizing entity. Now, if we go to the next slide, there was one major precondition, which was the cleaning up of national rules. Can you have the next slide, please, Rula?
Joseph, I think we have an audio problem.
Your micro, you should take it.
Your microphone is...
Yes.
So is it working now?
It's much better. Thanks.
Okay, thanks, Max. So Rula, can we go to the next slide, please? So one major precondition for the start of the technical pillar, for the start of the activities in the agency, and of course, a major step towards a single European railway area has been the reduction of national rules. Here, I show you the example of national rules for vehicle authorization. And when we started in January 2016, we had 14,312 such rules. Now, and this is the status as of September 2019, we have 1,061, slightly more than 1,000. This is to be compared to the 531 rules that are in the TSI, which is the long blue bar to the right of the slide. What is the importance of this? With the prevalence of the European rules, we will now be much closer to a situation where we have European vehicles on a European network. Now, on the next slide, we come back to the situation as of today. And it is my pleasure to welcome Croatia, Denmark, Germany, Latvia, and Slovakia in the technical pillar of the fourth railway package as of today. We have now a significant block of green countries covering more than half of Europe. The other member states will follow as of the 31st of October this year. This is thanks to the measures that were taken by the Commission. You see the two directives that were changed, and there is also a number of implementing and delegating acts that were changed because of the necessities of COVID. The implementing acts will enter into force as of today. If we go to the next slide, Rula, please. Obviously, the COVID-19 has also an impact on the authority activities. And here I am specifically referring to measures that we have taken in regard to vehicle authorization. There could be some issues with notified bodies not being able to completely cover all their activities. The Association of the Notified Bodies, NB Rail, have created a recommendation for use, which the agency have endorsed. And we have also defined a clarification note about the rules that the agency applies. Now we have also a similar clarification note on single safety certificates, where we also cover some temporary constraints that the applicants might face. And finally, we have also created some exceptional rules for the management of entities in charge of maintenance. All these clarification notes and all these documentation is available on the agency website. Now, with that, I would like to hand over to Thierry to tell us how did it go so far? What is our experience with the first year? Thierry, please, and Rula, please switch to the next slide.
Thank you, Josef. To start, a few figures on what we have achieved in this last year. As you see on the slide, for vehicle authorization, thus we have issued around 640 decisions until now. The majority of these were related to conformity to type, but you see that we have issued more or less 40 decisions other than this conformity to type. These represent that a little bit less than 8,000 vehicles are now be authorized by the agency. For the single safety certificate, we have issued 11 decisions, And we have as ongoing project, seven projects. For VA, I forgot to mention it, but as you can see, we are ongoing 56 projects, among which around 40 are for cases older than the conformity to type. Thus, you understand that we have in our portfolio of project to manage quite a huge number of processes that our different teams are dealing with. For the RTMS track site, as you certainly know, the first step in our process is related to initial engagement. This is a step in the process where, in a few meetings, we exchange with the applicants on the planning, on what are our expectations, what are the issues that they need to address in their application file. Thus, for this and this initial engagement, we have had 13 already ongoing initial engagement, for which 5 has been already closed. And currently, we are dealing with 6 applications for the ERTMS track site approval. If we go to the next slide, what makes us proud of what we have achieved until now? First of all, the process that we are following. This process has been designed and developed together with the sector representatives and the national safety authorities during a lot of workshops that we have held here in Valenciennes. What we can see after 1 year of experience, even if this experience is still limited, is that we don't see major problems, we don't see major shortcomings in this process. This it means that the process that we have designed all together fits really with the need of the fourth railway package. Second main aspect is related to the expertise of the agency. Before the 16th of June 2019, we met some stakeholders who were quite skeptic on the ability of the agency to deliver these decisions. But what we can see after 1 year of experience is that the skills and the expertise of the agency staff is now very well, very good and is very well recognized within the sector and allow us to take the decisions according to the legal framework. A third aspect, which is working very well, is the collaboration with the different national safety authorities. Even if at the beginning we had to fine-tune this collaboration with the 8 national safety authority of the member state has been transposed, which has transposed in 19. Now what we can see is that this collaboration is very good and allow us also to, together with the national safety authority, to take the decision in the due time. This has been certainly helped by the workshops that we have organized in the agency, workshops during which we have trained our staff, we have trained the staff of the National Safety Authority. This has also been an opportunity for our staff and the National Safety Authority experts to meet, to have discussions. And then I would say this really contribute to the team spirit that we need to have with these authorities in the project that we are dealing with. One achievement also was the establishment of the clarification note. We have seen that sometimes it is necessary to give additional information or clarification for the legal framework. The initiative first on the VA team in the agency, we drafted clarification note aiming to present to the sector, to the applicant, what are our expectations for this specific topic, and also ensuring that for all the different applicants, for all the different applications, we will have an harmonized way to deal with these different aspects. And then finally, I would say one aspect where I'm very proud of the teams is the support that we are providing to the applicants and the NSAs. Early in the process, our program managers are starting to take contact with the NSAs and the applicants, having exchange, understanding of the application file. And during all the process, we are in close contact with the applicants and the NSAs to help and to contribute to the success of this fourth railway package. Next slide, please. But all these achievements and this positive aspect should not make us blind. Thus, we need to recognize first that our experience is only limited with a limited number of member states having transposed and also a limited number of cases. We have issued a lot of decisions for VA, but we also know that, and I have explained just before, that a majority of them are conformity to type. Thus, we are still discovering also some aspect of the process. And in terms of process, and mainly for the ERTMS track site approval, we have not yet exercised the complete process. We are still on an ongoing project. We have not yet made decision. What it means that all the conditions for having the full benefit of this single unified process has not yet been put in place. Next slide. What are the main difficulties that we are encountered? First, the difficulty linked to the novelty. The agency is a new actor. It takes time for the applicants. They were used with the way of working, they were used on what are the expectations from the different national safety authority. Now the agency has a key role in this authorization cases. We need to work to make sure that all actors now are in line with the fourth rail package. We have also a new process, new authorization case. That's what we see is that it still needs in the different application to explain, to discuss this with the applicants. Even if these requirements are not new by such, like safety culture, human factor, requirement capture, the evidence that are required to be provided by the applicants to the authorizing entity are different in the fourth rail package, and we see that this gives some difficulties for the applicant to provide these evidences. The fourth rail package provides also more freedom, but also more responsibility for the applicant. And we need also, and we see this on the different application file, that we need to further explain this and discuss with the applicant. And finally, in terms of novelty, we have also the one-stop shop. The one-stop shop is our IT tool, allowing all the exchange of information between the applicant and the national safety authorities and the agency. The one-stop shop starts with the submission of the application by the applicant, allow exchange of issues between authorities and applicant, and they record all the decisions. And we see that also this needs to be further developed and improved. Next slide, please. In terms of the slide before, sorry. In terms of difficulties, what we have seen also is that there is a lack of familiarity with the new legal framework from some applicants. This is important that we are in the position to continue to explain and to disseminate this legal framework. Another aspect that we have seen is the accuracy of the information that we have in the registers. Starting in June 19, we were quite a little bit surprised on the lack of information that all the different actors, conformity assessment bodies, NSAs, applicants, were registering in this database. We have proposed a workaround that will be finished by the end of this year to face this problem, but we really encourage all the different stakeholders to record all this information that we need in the register for being able to take the decision. Another difficulty that we also see is the cleaning up of the national rules. There have been a huge progress, as explained by Joseph just before, performed on this aspect. but we still see in the different projects that there are some rules that are not notified, still requested by the different national safety authorities. Thus, we need really to continue to the cleaning up of these national rules. We have faced also some problems of interface with the national procedural rules, meaning that some administrative rules are still applicable in the different national legal framework, and this can pose some problems when we are the authorizing entity. Important aspect is related to the cross-border agreements. Within the Force Railway package, when we have similar network characteristics and similar operational rules, there is the opportunity provided to the applicant to select a cross-border station. In this case, the NSAs of where this cross-border station is located does not need to be involved in the process because there are agreements between NSAs allowing the other NSA to take the decision. What we see in the project and the different project is that these cross-border agreements are not yet in place, and this gives quite a lot of problems because we cannot, in the framework of a project, have the discussion on these cross-border agreements. Thus, we really now encourage all the NSAs to continue to work on this cross-border agreement, to sign them, to make and to give the benefit to the applicant of this possible agreement. And finally, in terms of difficulty, what we see is that the time to deliver the conformity to type, even if we have far beyond the legal framework of 1 month, is still seen by the sector as too long, that we are not yet meeting the expectation of the sector for this. We continue to work on this. We continue to automatize our way of working, but we also encourage the applicant to improve the quality of their file in order to allow us to meet their expectation. Next slide. On the OSS, it's a new IT platform allowing us to have all this exchange. The first time we put the OSS in production was in February 2019, where with this release, the applicant were in the position to prepare their application file. Finally, we put an OSS release in production on June 19, allowing the 8 NSA, the agency, and the applicant to work on this. And now, regularly, we have new releases put in place in order to correct some bugs, to improve some features, and to also make some further development. Since the beginning, what is working very well in the OSS is the phase of submission from the application. We have encountered not a lot of problem with this. The process for assigning the teams and providing access rights was also working very well, even if for some cases we had problems at the beginning. We exercised the use of the web form for the SSE already with the current release. And based on this, even if this provides sometimes a lack of flexibility, we will continue to develop this for the other domain, and the upload of reports and decisions from the authorizing entity was also working quite well. This being said, there are for sure, as for all the IT tools, a need for improvement. The first is a question of ergonomy. Sometimes the ergonomy could certainly be improved because the sequence of actions to be taken is not so obvious. Notification, we will need to revise because we have too much notification. We should perhaps put hierarchy between the notification because for the moment we have too much information. This is not really used. The dashboard also was not providing all the necessary information. We will have soon in the next weeks a new release making correction, but dashboard is clearly an item on which we need to improve. And as I said before, platform for the VA will also have to be put in place. Next slide, please. What are now the next steps for us? The first, as authorizing entity, we will have certainly to reinforce our operational collaboration with all the NSAs. Because at this stage, as we had only 8 member states having transposed, because we have more had bilateral meetings with the NSAs solving problems. Now, the project teams, certainly with corridors, will be very big in terms of authorities. Thus, we will need to improve this collaboration with all the NSAs. We will need to continue to fine-tune the process and the OSS, always taking into account our return of experience. We will need to continue to inform the stakeholders on the FOSALU package, on the process, on the tool. Now, I will say this is perhaps one of the positive side of the COVID, that we have seen that we can have also this type of dissemination by other means, that we will also investigate online meetings, e-trainings, but clearly dissemination will needs to be continued. And as we have already started, and because we believe that this is a very useful and power tool, when we need to provide additional clarification, we will continue to issue a clarification notes. That's next slide. But we are also expecting some improvement from the applicant side. The first one is related to the quality of the application files. Too often, we see incomplete application where some obvious information like certificate or declaration are missing. What we see also in the application file is that when we have a submission of a second application file very similar to the previous one, we see repetitive issues that we need to raise for which we are spending a lot of time, a lot of exchange. Because really, we believe and we ask the applicants to improve the quality of their application file. Second point is on the planning. There are two aspects behind this point. The first one is we really urge the applicant when at the beginning of the project they are making their planning to take into account in their first planning the time that we have in the legal framework to take the decision. We too often see planning where already well in advance the applicant are only providing the authorizing entities a few months, 1 or 2 months for the decision. Just please at the beginning respect the legal framework. And behind this point of planning, there is also the aspect that we should work all together on the plannings. First, long-term planning, allowing the authorizing entities to resource the coming application, and then a short-term planning. And certainly this is very important for comfort community to type, to announce a few days, a few weeks in advance, which application will arrive in order to allow us to put in place the right team and the right expert on the application file. A third aspect that we really encourage the applicant is early contact with the authorizing entity, either via a chargeable service of pre-engagement. This is a very powerful tool for the applicants to enter in contact with the authorizing entities, have first exchange and secure the content and the planning of their project. And then last item is that for some aspect, like, and I take here the example of the requirement capture, it is clear that the experience and the expertise are inside the sector organization. And it's very important that the sector is organizing itself to contribute to this subject in order to provide their best practice. We can help in organizing exchange, we can help by providing this information application guide, but we really believe that for some aspects, like the requirement capture, the input needs to come from the sector first. I will give the floor to Joseph for the final conclusion.
Well, thank you very much, Thierry. I would like to apologize for the initial problems with the sound. So that is what happens when you are in a live event. My headset fell off, but I hope that we are now back to a good and acceptable sound quality. Now, you have seen from the presentation of Thierry that during our first year, we have gathered a lot of experience, and the experience so far has been quite positive. On that basis, we believe that the NSAs, the agency, but also the applicants are well prepared now for what we could call the second wave, starting today with five new member states and with all the other member states by the end of October. However, we should not forget that there were some objectives behind the fourth railway package, and we need to measure ourselves on the final outcome. We need to see whether the technical has really contributed to less cost, has provided better transparency, better predictability, reduced the risk, and simplified the extension of area of use. One conclusion of the first year is already quite clear. Cooperation is essential, and I'm very pleased that we could establish an excellent teamwork with the national safety authorities. And on the side of the applicants, Thierry has highlighted it already, please contact us as early as possible. The earlier you come to us, the easier it is to clarify the situation. And with that, I hand back to you, Max, for managing the question and answer session.